Okay, we're here at the waterfowl viewing area in Newmarket, on the way to Minden area, and just taking a nice walk here from our car.
I'm just worried, that's not where we're supposed to park.
I'm not sure how far this, where we're supposed to park, how far this goes. You can sit here. It's beautiful. Yeah, I'm not gonna go up there. It's too much climbing on the rocks. That's where this is cool. The other way seems like it's down, right? So I want to go that way. Over here, is this the end here? Or what? Didn't bring my selfie stick to hold this. So we are enjoying nature here. Beautiful nature walk. I'll catch you later. Make a big stop. Haliburton Forest sculpture, or sculpture forest. Yeah, there's no way to turn this thing around once it's gone.
Down.
I don't know where that.
I saw the trail. Oh. Yeah.
Trail
along. From academics in the what is it called? Survival room. Octagon. Ah, there's much birds sculpture. Right there. Big umbrella. Yeah.
Charming right now. A little while ago. There's somebody over there.
Stuck your hand in there.
Yeah.
Oh, that thing's got a hole.
Oh, you can go in there.
It's
a quickie.
Oh? Okay, we saw that thing though.
Yeah,
or
so.
Would that be another one?
No, that's the same one. So we're in that way now. You gotta go some other way, you said?
Go this way and go to this, inside this
what,
place.
What way?
Like
well, we were there.
I'm on this side of it.
Okay, fine. Right down.
Silence is the language of God. All else is poor translation.
There we go. Okay, so
wow,
we're
it's
inside.
Nice and cool and
it's got an opening on top. And let the sun in.
Can't be too tall to go out of here.
I'm gonna get a duck. So it seems like that doesn't go anywhere else. Unless that's a different trail, I think. couldn't see anything here. Oh, maybe this. No, that's just for this sculpture. Well, it's not there. No?
Well, we didn't go this
way. Oh, there is a trail. There is the trail. Right here. There is a trail here. Not there this way. Maybe this iron rusty horse or moose. That way and this way. There's some kind of bear here giving a ride to girl and boy. So that way. Or does this go down? No, this doesn't go. Yeah, this.
Oh, she's sleeping.
The lake over here. Oh. Somebody sleeping here. Yeah, so this is the lake back there, or the river. Yeah, so this trail doesn't go. There's a trail to the side of the river down. Yeah, you can actually see the water all the way down. Below. Okay. So let's go down this trail. Trail. Oh, there's another one here.
Steps.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost there. There's a little locomotive sitting area behind that. In fact, somebody started running out.
We don't have nothing for. Oh, you want somebody to play ball with you, eh?
He likes to show his ball off. Yeah. Okay. Come on, bud. Up the hill. Another bench here.
Mm-hmm.
The red one.
The bench. And the rock bench.
Yeah. Okay. Rock and steel bench added to it. This one ends. It doesn't end the ghost. Maybe it ends in the other parking lot.
see that birch? It had no leaves to way up there.
Yeah, it didn't quite look all the way up.
There's little maples beside it, but
yeah, I got it on video.
Looks like it has leaves in the poplar trees.
So I can go like this and destroy the trees. Tree tops. There's gabions.
Well, that's
small.
Yeah. Ooh, here it's pretty dead. No, I would live here.
Well, yeah,
nice
not
your vacation, but
not yes. We'd have to find a place where there's things. You know, not like
just enough boondocks. Wild, yeah, boondocks. That's what it is.
Whoops. Okay.
It wanted to trip me.
Yeah. Didn't succeed. Yeah, I think this must go around and then come into the other place.
Maybe. Let's find out.
Yeah. Because there was no other thing down there. Up there. Maybe just past the area here. There's no way out. You get swung around. See over here, there's these trees marked. The other way, there was a sculpture. Okay, so we got another one. So American Beach. Black cherry. So, out here it is. Okay, see, there's parking for the road. There's no shoe trail. Yeah, see? And there's no shoe trail that way. So I think the parking is back here.
Yes.
The washrooms are.
Museum?
Oh yeah, there's a museum here. This is that too. And it's open.
Scrolling, so you'll wait for 10 minutes and you wait for me, I think.
I'll get something too, some kind of prints. Yes. That's an old newspaper.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. They're made from wood, probably. Charcoal. I suppose it's by a charger. You can see it there. That's how they make it. Okay. Who's upstairs? Our visitors. We are currently facelifting chambers. So this was a Polish for a master called occupied. Okay, so open, I guess. Stick these out so you can see. Upstairs.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
Old tools.
Yeah. Old tools for rail. Some
They have little tools or types, surveyors, old surveyors, this area. Used for fishing, you know? There's a hook attached to the.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's got for the wire too. So they used to use. Some pictures from the old town. Old register.
Cash register.
That's a real oldie. That's their army.
I'm pretty excited.
Yeah?
Yes, we're probably going to reorient the group.
So about
if that works for you.
Well, it works for me.
Okay.
If that is good by you, then.
It's actually better by me because it's got a lot of light.
Oh,
okay. So checking
well,
out
there you go.
Hopefully.
And it gives you a hard time because you say, I need to let you see.
Yeah.
There's another one.
Not that's friendly. All right. Perfect.
Yeah.
Do we get one
more
question?
Oh, this must be an invoice.
Machine.
Like that.
Yeah, I think we'll have it. We'll just reach any of these ones.
All invoice machine.
Oh.
It's real, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is some kind of contraption too.
Well, I hear you've had a busy summer.
Oh yeah, you bet.
Haliburton Museum. But it shows museum this way too. It says Haliburton Highlands Museum. And
that's his farmstead.
Oh, that's his farmstead.
Oh. Yeah. Enjoyed it? You have a great day and we'll catch you later. Bye. That was 20 minutes. The old house. Can't go in, so can't go in. I'm not sure there was a entrance over there or something. Normally. Back here behind. Now there's a couple of sheds here and
outhouse.
Yeah.
Or is that an outhouse?
I think that's an outhouse.
No, it's a wood shed.
Wood shed, and so is that. Maybe that's how that was. From the other way. Let's see. Pass for it. Yeah. But it's locked. Okay, we can go this way.
Dining room, bedroom, and stove in the middle.
Oh yeah, look at that.
Spinning wheel.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
There is a rope around there.
Cradle.
See?
It's got the rockers on
it. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Real old preserved house.
Oh yeah, upstairs. Steps there going up.
Yeah. Loft.
A loft.
Okay. Yeah, well, and not now, I guess. Did you try that though? No, it's, I'm not sure it's closed. And there's a barn here. Check that out. Actually, I'm going to snap a picture of that here. Honey, hold this.
Talk to it. This is good old days here. There's an old plow. I don't know, that's why I was gonna go see.
Okay, let's go.
Barrels.
Back over here, this buggy shed. And some barrel. Yeah, so that's a barrel for something. Water or something.
Penstock.
Penstock. 400-foot penstock. Select commission. I'm not sure what that is. Maybe. School van body. There you go. Take kids to school. And there's the other part.
Oh,
that's yeah, machine. Look at that. Pretty much falling apart. Here, hold this, please. So we're gonna have
a small stove in that bus.
Wow.
Wow.
For winter, huh?
That's what it said. The stove was in the middle and the benches were on the side.
Huh.
Wow.
Yeah, it's the only way they could heat before. Another little outhouse or house, I should say, building. And there's a steam engine. Look at that.
Donkey engine.
That's his donkey engine. But it's steam, obviously. So we put wood and coal over here and build up the water pressure, and that moves this back and forth and turns the wheels here, which then is used for something else. That's just something else, generators. Okay. Interesting. Haliburton Hammond Museum. Main gallery, Writers Administration. Sculpture Forest, even there. And back there is the homestead, or farmstead buildings. Now we're gonna head to the car and look for some other tourist attraction on the way. Here in Haliburton, that's about half an hour from Minden, north from Minden. So we're gonna spend some time here and then find something else and we'll stop on the way. So check something else out. The one?
The information, they probably have some other stuff there.
Well,
they should.
You
think they would?
Yeah, probably pamphlets and attractions. Yeah. Okay, I'll catch you later. Bye now. Sculpture garden. Or forest.
Thanks.
We're walking around. Oh, here. You want to see us? So it's going to be a while. I'm not sure how it goes. There's a ball. Hula. This in Haliburton, Ontario. What is that? It's not an animal either. Yeah, there's metal. Rusty. The bench. What is this? Well, that's what sculptures are. Some things are just weird shapes. And they're nothing. Oh, yeah. But most are like this, made of steel, iron. So this goes up already. Wow. It's a sculpture. I thought it was all animals, I guess not. Some local thing accomplished. So which way to go? This way? Or that way?
That's the way to go.
Probably all ends up being one. Oh, look at this guy.
Mr. Beaver.
Beaver. Headless snow trail. I go to the snow. There's no sculptures there. It's a snow trail. Oh. Okay. Maze. Yep.
Okay.
Some more people's sitting. This way, going up, back.
Well, I did want to go get my shoes on, so.
And I can take this off. Which way is it? I don't think this is the same place.
The parking lot's across the...
Well, how do you get here? Some parking lot, not one over there. Some stone man like you have here.
Yeah, he's better looking than mine.
Yeah. It's hot out here.
Yes. This jacket will have to be.
Yeah, we can
shoes on.
may do so. To prove that any man or woman may do so and show how, my first step will be to lay down three fundamental propositions. First, we assert there is one original form of substance from which all things are made. All the seemingly many elements are only different presentations of one element. What does he mean by that? Let's look at it this way. I want you to imagine yourself holding a glass of water. What is your hand made of? Your hand is made of energy. It's a mass of molecules comprised of vibration. What's the glass made of? Made of energy. What's in the glass? Water. What's the water made of? Energy. Now, you take and boil that water, and it's not called water anymore, it'll be called steam. It's the same energy, just moving at a different speed. What's the glass made from? Energy. Used to be sand.
Hitchhike.
What we've really done is alter the molecular structure of the energy, and we turn the sand into glass. Still the same form of stuff. But you see, where we have a problem is that thought and energy is one. Thought waves are cosmic waves that penetrate all time and space. First, he said, we assert there is one original form of substance, and from which all things are made. But where does everything start? It starts in thought. What's thought? Thought's energy. Think of it. Thought waves are cosmic waves that penetrate all time and space. Do you know that thought would make the laser beam look puny? All the seemingly many elements are only different presentations of one element. All the many forms found in organic and inorganic nature are only different shapes made from the same stuff. And this stuff is thinking stuff. A thought held in it produces the form of the thought. Thought in thinking substance produces shapes. A human being is a thinking center, capable of original thought. Do you know that the one point all great leaders have agreed on, they've disagreed on virtually everything else, is that you and I become what we think about? That was the foundation of Earl Nightingale's strangest secret record. First recording that outside of the entertainment industry that sold over 1 million copies. And if you haven't listened to it, I'd suggest you go to the Nightingale Corning Corporation and buy it. It's incredible. 40 minutes of the best philosophy you're ever going to hear. And they're saying the same thing here. Thought in substance produces shapes. A human being is a thinking center, capable of original thought. That means you. You are a thinking center. You're the center of thought. Thought's omnipresent. Thought energy's everywhere. And this energy flows into your consciousness and you can think anything you want to think. Isn't that nice? And thought is the preamble to everything. Do you want to live a richer life? Start to think of a richer life. Do you want to live in a healthier body? Start thinking of a healthier body. Do you want to have more meaningful relationships? Start thinking of more meaningful relationships. If any one of us can communicate our thought to original substance, we can cause the creation or formation of the thing we think about. That's a huge idea. That's essentially what I did almost a half a century ago. Here I was broke, I was unhappy, I was sick. And I met a man that provoked me to look at that, look at the results I was getting, and he got me to admit I don't like these results. He said, quit thinking about those results. Start to think of what you want. Now let me just share part of the syllabus of this with you for once. There is a thinking stuff from which all things are made, and which, in its original state, permeates, penetrates, and fills the inner spaces of the universe. A thought in this substance produces a thing that is imaged by the thought. You can form things in your thought, and by impressing your thought upon formless substance, can cause the thing you think about to be created. Who does exactly what I say to do will get rich. I have said that an individual gets rich by doing things in a certain way. In order to do so, you must become able to think in a certain way. Your way of doing things is the direct result of the way you think about things. To do things in a way you want to do them, you will have to acquire the ability to think the way you want to think. This is the first step toward getting rich. To think what you want to think is to think truth regardless of appearances. You could very easily skip over that. I don't want you to. I want you to really mentally play with what I've just said. To do things in a way you want to do them, you will have to acquire the ability to think the way you want to think. In other words, if you want to live an opulent lifestyle, you're going to have to think that way. If you want to earn many times what you're earning without working hard, you're going to have to think that way. And you see, this is the first step toward getting rich. To think what you want to think is to think truth regardless of appearances. What Waddles is really saying is quit letting your physical world control your higher world. You know, if you were working with electricity, you always work from a higher to a lower potential. You never work the other way. Why is it in life we work from
here we are in Huntsville at Lion's Lookout. So as you can see over here, it's a lookout over the lakes. So we're gonna hit one of these trails here and show you around. But we'll go to the lookout over there, and from there look at the lake. It's quite a steep hill here, it's on top of a mountain. It's a nice, beautiful day. Too hot. It's like 18, just perfect. It's more breezy, not too humid, cloudy. So, I'm going to turn this on. Look at this view here. Beautiful. Look at that view. Wow. It's in Huntsville, Ontario. Beautiful place. Sun is starting to peek out from the clouds. Just beautiful. Road, but there's gotta be some trail somewhere.
We'll just take the road.
Yeah. No, that's just that bump so that people don't drive in there.
Ah, I don't mean.
Don't worry about it.
Well,
yeah.
Put your brakes on.
Let's see if there's some trail here.
Oh, interesting. It's pretty in there.
There's a trail, but it's another look of it. The city, I guess. Interesting. Ah, okay. How are your shoes? Cool. Wow. This is beautiful too, this way. Coming here. All right. Don't snap. Picture too. Again, with my camera. My trusty camera. There, I couldn't have the view, but yeah, beautiful. Look at that. Yeah, very beautiful. Like this. it up to. Yeah, I guess we move on down the road.
Yep.
Pressing down.
Well, yeah, of course. Do you tighten them good?
Yeah,
well,
these kind of laces you can't tighten. They're in the slippers. They're not proper shoelaces in them. That's okay. I will put some proper ones in once we get home.
A short distance, but I gotta use our brakes on that low gear to climb up. I think this may be a trail gym.
Looks like it.
Yeah, there's a gate there. Okay. Yep. Here's a trail. Track, yeah.
Okay.
Mm. Mm. Yeah. It's just a track. I don't feel like running in the sun.
Blazing here.
Yeah. Let's just go down the road.
Somewhere else.
Yeah. Oh, it's the road already.
Oh.
So I guess
but
there's
then, out that way.
Yeah, there's some trails.
Up there?
I guess there's not
some
right. Just
a lookout.
Yeah.
Less, I guess. Well, we'll have a lot till we get back up that hill.
Yeah. And get something there. Some monuments here. I thought there was some trails here somewhere. What is that? That's like
a
mill or something. Oh yeah, it's a steam engine. Look at that, it's in a running. Cool. And there's a lake down there too. Pontoon boat.
Yeah.
trail entrance right there. Yes, that's that way.
You go back up your car and then park here and you go back.
Wow, what's the difference?
Ten
minutes to do you have to go?
Oh, they take training
now. Oh, wow.
Let's see what this is.
Yeah. And actually, this is a steam engine train ride. Look at that. Train entrance open during rail operation. Okay. No pit. Ah, look at this. I guess we got a board over there.
Let's see what it is.
Yeah. Yeah, train station. When does the next one go?
It goes at... Well, when does it go?
Yeah, 1 o'clock. Okay. And how far does it go?
It goes... just under a kilometer down
Brooklyn
Road, and then it
goes back. Okay. Cool. Okay, so do we need a pickup or something?
Yeah. So is there the two of you?
Yeah. Actually, I'm gonna stop this slow and all that.
The Peninsula Lake and Lake of Bays was much too great for the dredging and too expensive for the manufacturing of a lock system. So this mighty train would carry a dozen people across approximately 1 1/8 mile of track to Lake of Bays, just a little farther than the track distance today. There was steamship clear across, carrying the last leg of the journey to the Tanny Inn, Point Ideal, the Wawa Hotel at Norway Point, and off to Big Island. Your destination today is our Fairy Lake Station, and that very building will serve as the actual purser's cabin at Norway Point, Lake of Bays. Quite often the weight of passengers and cargo was almost too much for this little train, and guests were expected to jump off and help push the flyer up the hill. Hopefully that won't be necessary today. The development of roads and increasing popularity of automobiles shut the flyer into obscurity. The train operated as a tourist attraction for one final year in 1959 and had a short stint in St. Thomas, Ontario, then was returned to this area as a result of many dedicated hands, minds, and contributions. This little train is a fond memory of Colonel visitors and locals alike who actually gave it the nickname the Portage Flyer. And we've enjoyed stories from many visitors to Muskoka Heritage Place who back in the day had ridden on, worked on, and even been married on the Portage Flyer. We hope you enjoy your ride back in time.
Thank you.
I can't read my proper glasses.
I can't read this. Yeah, looks like he's getting ready to leave. Hi.
Choo-choo train.
A real train. A steam engine train.
Okay, I'll pause this. Till we start going. Thank you. Okay, we're going to be 10-15 minutes here. I'm going to turn the engine around. And the little guys, if they want to jump into the cab with the engineer, we'll show them what the steam engine is all about.
Alright.
You want to go? You want to go?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. all the boiler and the water. What we have to do is put that water up, make it boil, and create steam.
Okay, so that was a little view of the engine and the actual burner. Oven. Okay. Give you another little tour.
That has to be covered with water. Whoops. Oh. Now what? Are we going
to get picked up by the
engine?
Oh, they're going to go through, then they're going to go there?
No, they're just going to turn down over there.
We're going to go to the back. Oh. Now this is the back.
Did you drop something there?
Yeah.
What is it?
It's okay.
Oh, it's right there.
Yeah. You can go get it if you want. Here, let me get it.
Thank you so much.
Oh, look at that. Sitting around, right? Look at that. Check that out. And there it comes.
It's gonna go that way, Mom.
No, it's gonna go here.
What? But he's gonna bark.
It's gonna push, yeah. It's gonna push all these wagons. We're gonna go on and it's gonna push us. Oh, it's gonna go in front. Okay. Pull us that way now. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna be on the other side.
Quiet.
Yellow board again.
Oh, bye!
No, you don't. There's nobody sitting. Oh, yeah. Just where they're sitting. Yeah.
And you know what? I bet you were going to hear the list today.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
There you go. There you are, guys.
Go.
Okay. Well, we got a little bit of a thing.